What, man?
Woke up feeling like I was on the moon. I woke up feeling like I need a honeydew. Look at the flick of that wrist. 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 Look at the flick of that wrist.
Look at the.
Stay your little punk, dirty, shit-stained ass inside.
Please do not be scared of this coronavirus.
What's up?
Scared of.
What's up?
Let me tell you something. God does not put the spirit of fear in us. Okay? So we cannot be scared of this virus. The only solution is to pray. And repent.
All right. How about a little something to try to make us all feel a little bit better? I'm going to start this song, and then I want all of y'all to add to it, all the musicians out there, all the singers out there. Change the key. Take it up. Yeah, let's see if I can do this.
Troubles in my way.
We need to work together to flatten the curve and fight off COVID-19.
Alexa, did the government release the coronavirus?
According to Event 201, the government planned this event, created the virus, and had a simulation of how the countries would react. This simulation occurred October 18th, 2019. The government released the virus among the population and has lost control of the outbreak.
I think we all know that it's the celebrities that we count on most. They're the ones who are going to get us through this.
Because if you quiet the feet or anything, that dog is going to come and get you, you understand? Okay. Keep your hands where they are. Keep your hands on your head. Keep your hands on your head. Put your hand on your head. Put your hand on your head. Stop pulling.
Let go of the thing.
Get
let go.
Let go of the car. Let go of the car.
Let go of the car.
Let go. Taser.
Let go.
Oh. Put your hands behind your back.
Top two taser.
No justice, no peace. 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 No justice, no peace.
No justice, no peace. No justice, no peace. No justice, no peace.
Nothing like some good old marijuana. Calm your nerves.
Hands up!
Newly released video in the heat of a drug bust takedown. An apparent suspect with a gun is shot.
Put your hands where I can see them! Gun! Gun!
But what Albuquerque Police Lieutenant Greg Brocco quickly realizes is he just shot a fellow cop.
Oh, that was Jacob! Are you okay?
No.
Come on out, dude. Come on. I'm sorry, man. I didn't know it was you.
You got them shorts on. Oh shit, you know I fucking love them shorts. Those shorts right there. You know you got the shorts on. I love those fucking shorts.
Hey, stop.
What?
No, you can't
fucking
touch me.
I'm your dad.
No, alright, you ain't my dad, but stop touching me. Stop. Don't touch me. Get off. Get off
of me. Hi guys, I hope you're all safe and healthy. I just wanted to come on here and remind you all to please stay at home. The situation is so serious and should not be taken lightly. It doesn't matter how young you are or how healthy you think you are, everyone can be affected. And I know you might be thinking, it won't happen to me. It will happen to you. My family has been personally affected. This morning I got a call about my cousin. She has the coronavirus. She hasn't been able to talk for a week. My family has to leave food outside for her because they can't come into contact with her. So people are suffering and things are happening. You know, she's young and she's healthy and we didn't think that something like this could happen. But it's very serious and we all need to think about not just us, but the people around us. You know, the U.S. Surgeon General even mentioned today that our generation needs to be just as cautious. So please, please, please think of the people around you. Think of yourself and your health and your safety, which always should come first. And please, please stay at home.
Let me check you out.
What I need to step out the car for?
The dead on dead boy, step out the car for
me. I'm saying, what I do though?
Step out the car for me.
Well, I gotta put that on the dead boy for. Look, sir. Look, you come over here. You put your hands up. You come. You stand your ass in front of my car. This the only way I'ma feel safe. You put your motherfucking hands up. All right. Don't reach for no gun. Don't do shit. Now tell me why you pulled me over. Don't call no goddamn backup. None of that. Tell me why you pulled me over. I ain't gonna shoot you, but this is the only way I feel safe. Y'all been killing motherfuckers this year. Y'all done killed about 6 motherfuckers. Now tell me why you pulled me over. This motherfucker didn't live. I be goddamn.
Hey guys, I wanted to come on here and say something about recent events. First of all, I don't think of myself as someone that speaks well on politics, but the nature of the events that have come up are so strong. Whether I speak well or not isn't important. It's a question of right and wrong. So I want to let you guys know that I stand with Black Lives Matter. I made a donation yesterday, and that there needs to be a systematic change in the police force. There needs to be a change in the way that they operate. We need to get rid of bad cops. One thing that I have been thinking about is to make it clear that the protesters and the looters are not the same people. So please, if you're faced with that conundrum where you go, how does looting help? Looting is a way of people expressing their grievances. And some people, yes, are taking advantage of the situation. But unfortunately, we're at a place now where that's just what has to happen for people to be heard. I've been just thinking about it all weekend. I've been upset all week. And this is going to be ongoing. This isn't over. And it's gonna take some time. Everybody stay safe, because bottom line, George Floyd was murdered wrongly. There's just no excuse for what happened. I've watched the video a bunch, and yeah, that's where we're at.
So y'all know me, I don't usually post serious stuff, right? I like to keep it light, but this broke my heart. The other night I was at the gas station. It was like 11 o'clock at night. There's this little old black man in front of me in line, hunched over, gray hair, must have been late 70s, early 80s, real old. Anyways, All he had was a 2-liter Dr. Pepper. He checks out, I check out, I go outside, get in my truck, I'm leaving the parking lot, and as I get to the exit, I notice that he's walking. And I know that road, there's nothing down that road for a good way. So I rolled down my window, I was like, hey sir, and he was like, yeah, and I was like, where you headed? He was like, home. And I was like, how far is it? He was like, it's like a mile and a half. And I was like, well, I'd be more than happy to give you a ride, it's late. And he looked at me and he was like, man, I don't know who you are. He's like, you could dump my body anywhere. He's like, I think I'd rather take my chances walking that mile and a half. And that broke my heart. How sad is it that that's where we've gotten to as a nation?
Y'all be sleeping, man. Y'all sleeping, man. Wake up, bruh. It's time to smell the roses.
Come here, guys. I got this $100 bill now. $100. If you can get this from up under this glass without touching this glass, you can't touch my glass now. You can have $100. Alright?
Alright.
You can get it from up under without touching, you can have it.
Bro, I just saw you put glue up under that, bro.
Up under the glass?
Yeah, up under the glass.
Nah, bro, ain't no glue. Hey!
A good harmless prank on the world sounds fine.
Hey! Come on, hey! Not on the fucking table, man! Mom! Mom! These fucking kangaroos are out here fighting! Come on, you guys are supposed to be fucking friends, man! Cut this shit! Hey! Listen, one of you motherfuckers is gonna get hurt! Mom! Call a fucking trooper! Come on, man! Break this shit up! Mom, I wanna go home!
This stuff boys shooting each other, that shit, that shit got me squashed, man.
You know what somebody told me about black people? And I had to believe it, and it hurt my feelings, but it's a fact. We forgive everybody but ourselves.
Do you know what I'm saying? Say it again.
As black people, we can forgive everybody but our own people. We need to start working on forgiving our own people and being better with ourselves, because as soon as somebody do something wrong to us that's not us,
we quick to say, we accept his apology. It's okay. But when we do it, man, fuck that nigga. I ain't fucking with that nigga. He did this and did that. We got to lose that mentality. That's that lynch mentality that they put in us that we have to get rid of and learn how to think for ourselves and say, if I'm going to be forgiving and loving and caring and acceptance of all, I got to be like that with my people as well.
And it's called Big Old Freak. It's a little more chill, but it's still raunchy. Hey, big old freak, big booty, big old treat. I'ma make him wait for the get it till he big old ski. Hey, feet on the bed, I fuck him up in the head. Suck it, then look in his eyes. Then the next day I might leave him on red. Hey, pop it, huh? They dreaming about how I rock it, huh? He hit my phone with a horse, so I know that me come over and ride it. I'm on the way, huh? Ride on the like gay. Hey, usually I like to. But tonight we gon' make love cause you babe, huh? Nobody know, him on the low. We never show up together, but I text him when I'm ready to go. Hey, I had a couple of shots at the bar. I'm finna play with that in the car. I got him swearing and breaking the law. These windows tinted so nobody saw. Freak like me, huh? Eat what you need like me, huh? Ain't nobody got a funny tip toes, then roll to the tip like me, huh? I got him addicted, he beaning. My body a drug and he need it. He begging me for the treatment. He threw a fit when I leave him.
All right, man, Uncle Steve weighing in on this battle thing. That took 15 people to get me to do this because they said, Steve, you need to weigh in on this. I done broke a lot of these songs they going to be battling with on the radio tonight, and you can ask them about that. People in my age group, we ain't got time to log back in and go back, and we don't know nothing about technical difficulty. All of it's difficult in my age group. So listen, man, we going to be tuned in, locked in tonight. I ain't got no dog in this fight. Just let's get it on. Let's make it right.
She know that poppy outside, she know I'm the king of New York. Niggas staying outside. Niggas staying outside. Send the addy, we gon' slide. Air it out when we arrive. Popping that shit, but they done with the smoke. She like it rough when we fuck, so I'm grabbing that bitch by the throat. Niggas staying outside. In the attic, we gon' slide.
Guys, I don't know if anybody else's dogs, when you're on a Zoom call, when you're recording a video, whatever it may be, they literally, it's the only time they bark. Don't bark the rest of the day. Only bark when I'm on a Zoom call.
Please notice how many police officers you see gathered together over here. And let's see if they're socially distancing. And let's see if they're wearing masks. Today is Tuesday, so I think it's May 5th. I don't keep up with the date as much as I'd like to. All right, let's count them. We have much more than 10, much more than 10, much more than 10. Who's in charge? Who's in charge? We're trying to figure out why you're not socially distancing and you're not wearing masks and you're clustered together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. So Mayor Garcetti, we have 20 police officers. None of them are wearing masks, and they're clustered together. But you shut down my church saying it was 10 or more. Let's get some names as they pass by. Clustered together, 20 of them, no mask. Mr. Garcetti, this is what your police department is doing. This is how they do it in South Central. This is how they do it. We do have a Sergeant McLean. I was able to get his name. This is how they do it. It's like a game over here in South Central. Then Blue Line, LAPD.
And I told her I was going to do it. Now, my mama got that $1,200 and ain't gave us nothing. No new snacks, nothing. She been making the room smell funny every day since she got that check. You think we got a video game or anything? No. No new snacks. No nothing. I'm giving her $48 to give us a PlayStation 5 or I'm reporting her to the government. Mm-hmm. Stimulus check. It's for all of us, mama. She got $500 for me, $500 for my brother, $500 for my other brother, $500 for my sister. You can count better than me. You know that's a lot of $500. I'm telling.
Right, and then I see the disinfectant where it knocks it out in a minute, 1 minute. And is there a way we can do something like that by injection inside or almost a cleaning? Because you see it gets on the lungs and it does a tremendous number of lungs. So it'd be interesting to check that. So that you're going to have to use medical doctors with. But it sounds interesting to me. So we'll see. But the whole concept of the light, the way it kills it in 1 minute, that's pretty powerful.
Hi, this is Ken Jung, and I just want to send all my thoughts, loves, and prayers to everyone affected with coronavirus, aka COVID-19, and just want to thank everybody for practicing social distancing, which is easy for me because I don't have any friends. But social distancing is 6 feet apart from everybody. Also, Dr. Sanjay Gupta said it best, behave as if you already have the virus. So behave as if you're already positive. Then what would you do? You would keep yourself socially isolated. You wouldn't want to infect anyone that you love or anyone around you. And that is social distancing, which is being 6 feet apart.
This for you, mama. Wanna leave me in a corner like this? Check it. It's Beast. Tell me, what did I do? Only thing I really did is ask for some juice. Never knew I was getting on your nerves, baby boo. You should have said something before you jumped out the roof. But it's all good because I'm chilling in the corner. Why you in the back smoking on that marijuana? Think I don't know, yeah, I smell the aroma. Weed so loud, you can smell it around the corner. This quarantine got you going crazy. You treat me like a man, but I'm just a little babe. Want me to sit down? Want me to shut up? Why you yelling at me like a sergeant in the Navy? I thought we was close like the rice in the gravy. Thought you had my back, but my mama turned shady. Switched on me, cause we in quarantine, acting like it's my fault, run, I got the world crazy. Like on the real, I don't appreciate none of this. I'd rather be in here, start chilling, counting blocks or something. Look at me, I'm in prison in here, man.
What happened? What happened, big man? What happened? Nigga, don't act tough, nigga. Don't act tough, pussy. Don't act tough, nigga. I put you on lock. Suck a dick. 3 million, nigga. You pussy. Fight me.
Yo, you know what got y'all bum ass hood niggas so tight? Y'all real niggas. Y'all gangsters. Y'all can't do. I'll do all the shit y'all could do. All this bum ass nigga shit y'all could do all day. I'll do this shit all day. You see me? You see the lights? Y'all can't do shit like this. Look, 200,000 on the fucking table, man. Let me try that, babe. What's that? Steak? If y'all can't do shit, I'll do the shit y'all do all day, every day. I'll just do it. This shit I'll do, shit y'all do, I can do every day. Y'all can't do the shit I do. Get this. That's a million in cash right there. A million in cash. Y'all real niggas can't do that. You heard? I'm out here comfortable. I eat where I want to eat. I do what I want to do.
Shut up, I'm broke.
Blue.
Don't click on that. Don't click on it. We have to focus on Red Nose Day. Keep your eye on the prize. You know what? Let's just do the second option anyway. It's easier. The phone. Just call. That's simpler because you just pick up your phone and... That is not a real monkey.
Hey, Mas. Hey. Yo.
Is that not enough to break your heart? Decency? Where's the humanity? Where is the concern? That is somebody's child. All those adults would never allow that to happen to their child, but for whatever reasons, they said it's fine to do it to this little boy.
Yo, what's up? This the homie Cube. I just want to talk to y'all, man. You know, straight up. No filter, no news, no nothing. Just straight up, me to you. You know, a lot of people think I've been on one for for these last few months, ever since George Floyd was killed. But I've been on one my whole career, so this shit ain't nothing new. You know, I felt like I've been ahead of the curve, and I've been waiting for people to catch up. We got shit to do, man. You know, it's an election coming up. I don't think neither party respect what we need done to close this wealth gap. And I think we gotta use our vote, this black vote, as a fucking tool. You know, some call it a weapon to get what we want. Don't matter which party give it to us, somebody got to get behind the contract with Black America. It's very broad. It deals with a lot of our pain, and it helps us catch up. You know, me, I ain't got nothing else I'm doing or passionate about but some change. You know, I don't give a damn about a movie or a fucking record or none of that shit. I care about changing it, changing the situation for black people in this country. And I want people, you know, to get behind it. You know, we got a short window. This is it. If we don't get it now, it might be another fucking 30 years before we get any of this. We got to go for it now. It ain't no time to play. You know, I don't want my kids, grandkids, great whatever, great grandkids, anybody after that to have to deal with this bullshit. We got to change it now. Straight up. We got to get serious. We got 92 days to push this program. I need all hands on deck. This your homeboy Ice Cube. You'll be hearing from me.
Real people want to get back to work ASAP. You never worked a fucking day in your life. You're worried about the next 4 years. You need to be worried about the next 4 days, motherfucker. You need to be worried about the next 4 weeks, the next 4 months, you motherfucker. You are the worst possible motherfucker we could have in power making decisions right now. The real people want to get back to work. Why don't you send your fucking son, Dick Stain Donald Trump Jr., Big Tooth fucking Eric Trump, little fucking Baron, fucking Ivanka, Junkyard Jared, let them go out there and test the fucking waters. Let them see.
I have heard enough. Do you not know how hard it was listening to you? Oh my God. But before I get started, let me tell you something, Michael. Look at me when I'm talking to you, Michael, okay? Listen and pay attention. Look at me when I'm talking to you. Don't you ever in your life, in your horrible, C-list acting life, ever put Barron Trump's name in your mouth again. He is a child. Leave his name out of it. And you have a filthy mouth. How old are you? You are like 50 years old, and all you can say is F this and F that? Come on, man. Is that all you have in your vocabulary? Seriously. No, I'm asking you a serious question. You have a filthy mouth. You know what? You are the definition of a ghetto piece of white trash. That's what you are. Yeah, I said it. Yeah, I said it. You are ghetto white trash. And you know what I'm starting to think? I'm starting to think you hating on President Trump for one reason, because you had a TV show that was a failure that only lasted, what, like half a season or one season? And President Trump had a show that lasted 15 seasons. Oh, yeah, I think you jealous. That's what it is. Mm-hmm. You never won an award. You never won a Grammy, an Oscar. I think you won something like Ghetto White Trash Award. That was all you won. But you never won anything serious. So you jealous of President Trump. That's what it is. And let me say something else here. Didn't I say look at me when I'm talking to you? Listen here, Michael. Don't you ever in your life disrespect President Trump again. And what do you mean he's never worked a day in his life? Oh, he's working. Oh, he's worked. And he's working for the American people right now while you are sitting on Twitter talking crap about the man who is keeping you safe in this country. About the man who wakes up every single day to make sure you are okay. The president is fighting and working for this country. So what are you doing? And since you want to bring up work, have you ever employed anybody? No, I don't think so. President Trump has employed over hundreds and thousands of people throughout his life. So many people were able to feed their children and pay their bills because of President Trump. What have you done besides get on Twitter and complain? Don't be mad because you are a C-list actor. Don't be mad